Good evening, everybody. Shadow of Order here. Welcome back. What was that? Oh, the lava's rising. What the? What am I supposed to do? What am I doing? It's not. There we go. It didn't do that the first time. Okay, that one was on me. I knew there'd be a thing like that in this, though. Chapter X. And I got the one thing that was in there. Good. I don't want to do that. Oh, only two in this last... Hold on. There's two chapters here that aren't on the book. They're on the map. They're right down there at the bottom, though. Necromancer's Abyss.
And so it begins. The Necromancer's Abyss lies at his feet. He is dark and terrible, and the cries of the dead follow him wherever he goes. There is nothing but hate in his heart. Hate for those who have taken his beloved, who have made him do terrible things, who have taken his humanity. Now, reap the whirlwind, scions of death, for comes the Prince of Darkness.
The Prince of Darkness, yeah. He is dark and terrible. The cries of the dead follow him wherever he goes. Who has he killed? He's killed monsters, lots and lots of monsters. No people, though. I mean, technically, I guess some of the vampires could be considered people-like, but two people, total. Vampire Lord, werewolf lord. They're the only ones who've actually talked. I guess goblins as well. Goblins probably count. But to be fair, they attack first. That's a giant bone from a dragon, I guess. Is it spiraling around the tower? Oh, look at that. Look at those floating rocks. Yeah, I'm definitely in the underworld. But there's floating rocks everywhere. There is a message that appears frequently in necromancer's lore, sometimes referred to as the key, which seems important to enter the domains. The fourth week of the month of the Virgin, the shadow will be more powerful than the light, and the path to the abyss shall be revealed. I've been waiting for that day for months now, but it seems time has frozen since I arrived. Fourth week of the month of the Virgin. Well, you can still see the sun just a bit. Oh my God. I totally thought that would be the trick. Okay, the second one seems to control only the moon. I think this is it. In this world, time is... When did I enter another dimension? Because this is totally a different dimension. What is that? Up to the left? Oh, that does not look fun. Either that or it's going to be really fun. I like these. These are fun. More puzzles. Okay. What do you got for me, friend? Two puzzles and one? What? Colors are movement. Got that in my head. That was what the witch said before bringing me here. First I didn't know what she was talking about, but now I am sure there's related to these tiles on the ground. Up, right, right. Okay, let's see what that does. Okay, there we go. Okay, these are up. Up. Right, up, up. Is this left? Left, then this must be down. Down, left, up, up. Right. Up. Simple. Hold on. Got something on my tooth. Alright. Much better. Oh, that's probably what I was seeing. Reaper. Only powerful sorcerers can summon and control these dangerous spirits. The Reapers are a corporeal manifestation of death itself. Their aspect depends on the belief of those who confront them, but most people perceive the Reapers as skeletal figures with long tunics wielding large scythes. Oh, so what it shows up as depends on what you believe it to be. But this is just a... It's a manifestation of death, but not a strong one. Sort of like a weak Grim Reaper. Sort of like an echo of the Reaper. Not the true Reaper. Or perhaps, yes, of the true Reaper, but not much of him. Okay, this is what I saw. They're gonna pop out of the... Okay, I thought it was gonna pop out of the coffin. Sorry. Oh, thank God. I don't have a lot of health. But listen to that music score. And it stopped. Sorry? Did that just take out... It's death himself, okay. Yeah, even if it's a small bit of him, that's... A single strike from that thing kills you, okay. Right. If I... had known that... Right. Stay far away from the Grim Reaper. I got that bit now. Reaper kills you in one hit. I could have waited till I got closer, huh? I look like I'm sinking into the rock. Alright, here we go. Once more into the breach, my friend. Oh, a necromancer! From the game. Necromancy is the most evil of all the schools of magic, can only be performed by the followers of the Dark Lord of the Dead. Can only be performed by the followers of the Dark Lord of the Dead. He's got a monopoly on that. Unlike vampirism and lycanthropy, the power is necessary to control the energy of the deceased and not easily acquired. Okay, yeah. Vampires and werewolves is just... Alright, you got it, you're in. This, though, is like, oh, you want to be a necromancer! Study this! Dark Lord only shows a small part of his power with his followers, who themselves must die in order to use the abilities to them, given to them. Once dead, they become his thralls, and their master is able to control them with his own considerable power. Oh, where the others are like... Okay, no, it's not even a study thing, it's just... Is this literally just the Gravedigger fight again? Oh, he puts a bit of his soul into this. Okay, yeah, he puts a bit of power into a bit of his life force in each of those things he summons. Please tell me that's not a thing I'll have to fight regularly. Two portals. Okay. That is actually where I'm going to have to end this episode for the night. I will see you in the next one. Till then, have a good evening, everybody.